संभावना ज्वाइन नहीं, ज्वाइन टिल नाउ नहीं, ओके माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल। ओके आई एम शेयरिंग द स्क्रीन नाउ। ओके माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। सो मूव टू द लास्ट टॉपिक इन द फर्स्ट यूनिट मीन्स सॉरी थर्ड यूनिट। So I am giving what is so your use case estimation is based on the calculation with the following elements: unadjusted use case weight and unadjusted actor weight and technical complexity factor and environmental complexity factor. So this is we are taking online shopping example for calculating UCW and UAW and TCF and ECF. So we are using this online shopping system for this. These are the unadjusted use case weights for here for different classifications are there: simple and average and complex. So here number of transaction between 1 and 1 to 3 is weight is 5 and 7, 4 to 7 is 10, and more than 8 transaction we are using the weight 15. So by using this table, we are calculating the UCW. So yesterday we discussed about all these things. So this is the formula for UCW. So total number of simple use cases into 5 plus total number of average use cases into 10 and total number of complex use cases into 15. So from the above online shopping, so there are here use cases are in this example. Use cases: view product, purchase products, manage customer information, create product review, manage products, report products, fulfill order, report inventory, manage inventory. All these are 9. Total 9 use cases are there. By using this, we have to categorize it into 3 types. One is 2 is simple, 3 is average, and 4 is complex. So by using this, we have to substitute these values in the above formula. So 2 into 5 plus 3 into 10 here. 3 into 10 plus 4 into 15 got the value is 100. Okay. That is about unadjusted factor weight. Okay, next we move to the this is unadjusted. This is about unadjusted use case weight. Now we move to unadjusted actor weight by using so this is the table for these are also actors. In this example, use cases are classifications are there. Here actors are classified into 3 categories: simple, average, complex, and type of the actor. The weight is given here. So for this, the formula is total number of simple actors into 1 plus total number of average actors into 2 plus total number of complex actors into 3. So from above example online shopping system, the actors here online customer, marketing administrator, payment processing system, warehouse clerk and warehouse manager, all you'll find there are totally 5 actors are there. So we have to categorize into 2-1. So one is simple actor and 4 are complex actor. We do not take any average actor, so it's here we will take the value 0. So total is 13. Okay, clear? So then we move to the technical complex factor. So this is the technical complex factor table. So totally there are 13 factors are there. So each factor has a given some value. Okay. So these factors with assigned values will the we have to calculate the technical factor. The sum of weight and assigned values we call it as a technical factor. So here technical factor is 42. So here 42 by 100 that equal to 1.0. For the above online shopping system, the example is the value is 1.02. Okay. Next one, that is environmental complexity factor. So here environmental complexity factor classified into 8 factors. So with weights, okay. So these are the values given for the online shopping system. So here also we have to multiply the weight with assigned values. Then we have to get the total EF value. That is environmental factor value, that is 10.5. So we have the formula here, ECF equal to 1.4 plus minus 0.03 into EF. So see here, EF is 10.5, so we are getting the value 1.085. So yesterday we will discuss all these four categories. So now we have to calculate the use case points, UCP. So here use case points UCP equal to UCW plus UAW into TCF plus into EF. Okay. So we already calculated UCW is 100 and UAW is 13 into, we already calculated TCF and EF, so the value is 125.06. So use case based value is 125.06. Clear? For online shopping system, for example, 28 maximum hours per use case point is used. So if the 28 hours per use case point is used, then we have to calculate effort will be 125.06 into 28, that equal to 3501 hours. Okay. So this type, this way we have to calculate the UCP, use case point. When we know use case point, when we calculate the use case point, we must know UECW and UAW value and TCF and EF values also. Then only you get the UCP value. If you want to know the UCP effort, you have to multiply the UCP into hours or UCP, hours per UCP. UCPs are based on use cases and can be measured very easily in the project life cycle. So it mainly based on use cases. Okay. So UCP will be independent of the size, skill and experience of the team that implements the project. Okay. So UCP based estimations are found to be close to actuals when estimation is performed by the experienced people. Okay. So UCP is easy to use and does not call for additional analysis. This is another advantage in UCP. And in this way, another advantage is use cases are being used vastly as a method of choice. Vastly as a method of choice to describe requirements. So in such cases, UCP is the best suitable estimation technique. Okay, these are the advantages of UCP. Next, we move to the disadvantages. So UCP can be used only when requirements are written in the form of use case. So when we have only use cases only, then we have to implement UCP. Okay, if there are no use cases, we cannot implement use cases because we have to use cases only. We can implement use case point. So depending on goals oriented, well written use cases, if the use cases are not well or uniformly structured, the result UCP may be not accurate. If they are not in structured manner, the result may not be accurate. And here, technical and environmental factors have high impact on UCP. So here, care needs to be taken while assigning values to the technical and environmental factors. So we have to take care when we are choosing technical and environmental factors. Okay. Then we move to next disadvantage is when UCP is useful for initial estimate of overall project price, but they are much less useful in driving the iteration to iteration work of a team. So this is another disadvantage in UCP. So this is the completion of third unit. So anybody has any doubt, please write a message in chat box. These are the tables. We have to remember the unadjusted actor factor. We have to remember the formula. Okay. So I am taking the values of the online shopping system. Okay. Any doubt? So I'm using the previous, I'm revising the previous topics. Okay. Saturday we move to the Monday we will discuss about new unit, fourth unit. So today I am revising the previous topics. Okay. So we move to the third unit, part A. We move to the third unit, part A. Okay, move to the third unit, part A, that is estimation, effort estimation, activity planning. So all of you are familiar with the effort estimation or any doubt on this? I'm explaining Kokomo model. So So these are the techniques for effort estimation, that is algorithm or parametric model, analog model, expert judgment, Parkinson, price to win, and top down approach and bottom up approach. Okay. So I am discussing the formula related topics. So see, a top down approach parametric model will be calculated with effort equal to system size into productivity rate. Okay. So effort equal to system size into productivity, right? System size is represented in the form of KLOC, that is thousands of lines of code. You have to remember this KLOC means thousands of lines of code. For example, see here, for example, and Ananda estimates a module to be completed as 2K LOC, and he is assisted it would be take 40 days per K LOC, and to work it takes 80 days. Okay, so we have the formula is so while another person can, who is less experienced, would need 55 days per K LOC. So that is 2 into means already 2 KLOC we are given there. So 2 into 55, that equal to 110 days. Okay. So that is calculated the effect. So see the formula related topics I am explaining here. So then see here, functional point analysis, Albrecht function point analysis, it will take so it comprises of four major components: external input types, external output types, external inquiry types, and logical internal file system, external interface file system. So in this Albrecht complexity multiplexer table is there. Here you will give the values for the multipliers. If the external input type is low, he will give 3. So actually, external input type means these are the input transactions made by the user. So if the input transaction made by the user, the multiplier value is low means 3, average 4, and high is 6. Then we move to the external output type. So these are the transactions where data is output to the user. So you will give the multiplier value when low 4, average 5, and high 7. And the external inquiry type. So see here, the transaction made, user provides the information but do not update internal file type. So you will give the multiplier value low 7, average 10, and high 15. And then move to the logical internal file type. Sorry, external inquiry type, low 3, average 4, and high 6. Next, logical internal file type. Here, standard file used by the system. So it refers to the group of data items that are usually accessed together. So here, for multiplier, we will provide low 7, average 10, high 15. Next, we move to the last one, external internal phase type. This allows for output and input that may pass to and from the computer application. Okay, you will give the multiplier value low 3, low 5, average 7, and high 10. Okay, so see here, this is the internal file type complexity. So they derived few rules to decide the complexity level of the project. This is IFPUG, that is International Functional Point User Group. So this is derived from Albrecht complexity multiplier table. So previous table we have derived this. So for example, So for example, file may contain data about the purchase order. Okay, data about the purchase order and a purchase order with item. So here the contain the data about purchase and the purchase order weight by organized in two types. One is purchase order and purchase order weight, order item. Okay, thus see here the purchase order details. In this purchase order, we are deals with the order number, supplier reference, and order date. Okay, and in the purchase order item, we deals with the product name, price, and number of items order. So here number of record types if two, purchase order and purchase order item, and the data types for each is three. For this order number, supplier reference, order date. For this product name, price, and number of items order, so total three plus three, total six data types. So by seeing the table IFPUC file type complexity, the data types are six. So number of records are two and data types are six, that is less than 20. So the complexity is low. So according to this table, the file size of this is would be low. Okay. So then we have then move to the next one. See here function point mark 2. So here for each transaction we have to calculate UFPS. For each transaction you have to calculate UFPS, that is unadjusted function point. So WI is the number of input data elements types plus W is the number of entity types referred, and W O is the number of output data elements. Okay. So for example, you have assuming the weights So I am revising the topic. So my screen is visible. Voice is audible. Please write a message in chat box. So this is function point two. So we are taking, for example, the average weights are W i 0.5 and W e is 1.66 and W o is 0.26. So we have to multiply with so we have to multiply with the these values first we have to multiply W i into number of data elements. For the above example, I is 3 and entity type is 2 1 2, and the output data elements is 1, so we have to get 5.32. so next we move to the functional point. Next we move to the cosmic full functional point. So here cosmics means common software measurement consortium. Okay, so data groups are classified into 4 ways. So actually it was developed in Canada. Cosmics deals by composing the system into hierarchy of software layers. So here cosmic model is helpful in a real time and embedded applications. Okay, so here there are data groups are classified into 4 ways. Entries e exist x, reads r, write w. Okay, this is about cosmic full function points. So next we move to the COCOMO. So I am revising the topic COCOMO. So this is used for COCOMO is used for construct to cost model. So COCOMO is used for time, cost and effort, used for estimating time, cost and effort. COCOMO was proposed by Barry Boehm in late 1970 after study of 63 projects. So my voice is audible. So my voice is audible, and just write a message in chat box.
So see here, in this here we have the formula. This COCOMO is proposed by Barry Boehm in 1970. So the basic model was built around the equation effort equal to c into size power size exponential k. For where effort is measured in person per month. So remember the formula person per month. Here size is measured in KDSI. Okay, so KDSI means thousands of delivered source code instruction. So KDSI means thousands of delivered source code instruction. So here is C and K are constant. So in this the COCOMO, don't write any personal messages. So in this COCOMO system classified into 3 ways: organic mode, embedded mode, and semi-detached mode. In organic mode, this is actually with small teams with complex projects, which generally consisting of 2 to 50 KLOC. So for example, that is a payroll system. So for college point for the faculty. Next embedded system, this means typically with very large teams, with high complexity and with high with very high constraint. So generally more than 300 KLOC. So example is real time applications like ATM. Okay, clear? Then move to the semi detached. So it is a combination of both organic and embedded. It has a medium level team with average complexity. So example for a semi detached is database system. So see here the table here, COCOMO table constraint for C and K. For organic, it will give the C value is 2.4 and K value is 1.05. A semi-detached 3.0 C value, K value is 1.12, and embedded C value is 3.6, K value is 1.20. So for exponent value, when it is greater than 1 means the larger projects are seen as requiring a more proportion than the smaller ones. So then we move to the COCOMO 2. So in COCOMO 1, the COCOMO is not support the high level language and updated tools. So we are here there is again again study of 160 projects with various multiplier exponents, constant values, which were initially set the projects. So here COCOMO 2 comprises support for various development methodologies such as component-based development prototyping, fourth generation programming languages and case support tools. Okay, here so COCOMO 2, we have three different stages is there. Application composition, early design and post architecture. So you have to just you have to remember the formula. Here PM equal to A into size power SF. Okay. So PM is person per month and SF is equal to size SF PM 1 is this experiment drive rating by calculate this experiment drive rating. Here A is constant, B is 0.91 and here size is measured in KDS, okay. So that is thousands of derived source code instruction. So the qualities of the project are listed below. But depending on these values, how to identify the quality of the project, that is precedentness, PREC, precedentiness and next one, development flexibility, FLEX, and architecture risk resolution, RESL, team cohesion, TEM, and process maturity. So when we see the example, you have to identify the flex RESL team PMAT is very low or low, normal, high, very high, extra. You have to decide by reading the new project. Okay, so see this example. So in this so see here I'm developing so a software package for an educational institution that would automate various academic activities such as course registration, grading, etc. So here the size of the code is written in 10,000 SLOC. So we have to calculate size in KSDA. So here 10K SDA value is we are taking here. So first we have to identify the tracks for repeating already existing process we are using here, so that's why we are giving here tracks value is very high. And what is flex? So here flexibility is more because the higher we are taking the experiment value, so we are taking here if the flexibility is less then we have to take high value, but if the flexibility is more, here flexibility was more in this example, we are taking low value. Okay, then resolution. So there are changes made in this project, so we have to take high. RESL is high, and team we are requiring even large team, so we are taking the value is very high. And team at here quality of the project, we want good quality. So for good quality, maturity is very high, and adult development is very low. Okay. So we have to substitute taking the values from the table. We have to substitute in the scaling factor formula. B plus equal to 0.01 sigma experiment rating. We are taking the value from the above table and sum them. We are getting the value 1.08 for Cmat and 1.08 for mature process. Then we have to substitute the person per month. So we get the value. So 10, we have here they given 10,000 SLOC. So we are converting into K SLOC. So we are taking size is 10. So PM value is 5.3436 per month. Okay, clear? So next we move to that is, this one is very important. So adding the time dimension. So here given the activity with duration and precedence here. So here by using the time dimension, we have to this precedence network we have to develop by using this time table. So see the example here. So we have to use two passes only. One is the backward pass. So the method requires the estimation duration for each activity, forward pass and backward pass. So if the project works and in start in correct time and ends in the correct time, then only the project is success. Otherwise, the project will not success very useful. The project will not success. Okay. So see here, forward pass. We have to start here. Initial end with 6 weeks. Completion 6 weeks, and B end with 4 weeks. And only after C starts after A is completed, because A is the precedence of C. So after A completed, C starts. So after 6 weeks, C will start. Then C will end after completion is 3 weeks. So 6th C, after completion of 6 weeks only, C end. Okay. Similarly, D. So similarly, B in previous B ends with 4, so C starts with after 4 weeks, then ends with 8 weeks. Then E starts with 4 weeks and ends with 7 weeks. So this is forward pass. Then move to H. H will start until D and C is completed. So here D is completed in 8. So C is completed, so it will take the time duration 9 weeks. So it starts with 9 weeks and ends with 11 weeks. Okay. Here G starts with F ends with 10 weeks, so G starts with highest duration is 10, so G starts with 10 and ends with 13, 6 weeks or 3 weeks. Okay, this is not 6 weeks, 3 weeks. So 13, so the overall project is end with highest duration is, that is 13 weeks. So everybody clear, understand about forward, but it is you may understand mainly the backward pass. So that is how to identify here. See the table. The first one is starting time. This one is ending time. Okay. In C, 6 is start and 9 is end time. For H, start time is 9. See that table here, diagram here, and end time is 11. By using these values, you have to backward pass. So backward pass starts, forward pass starts from left to right. Backward pass starts right and ends from left, right to left. Okay. So see here, the project is ends with in both cases 13. See the table 13. Okay, so when the H start and when the G start means, so H start 13 minus 2, that is 11. See here, H table 9 below 11. Here 10 minus, this is 3, so 10 minus 13 minus 3, that is 10. Okay, then after 11, when will the C start and when will the G start? So 11 minus 3. So 11 minus 3, C starts at 8 and 11 minus 3, 11 minus 4, D starts at level 7. Okay. And F also 10 minus 3, 7. And C here A starts 8 minus 6, that is 2. And B starts 7 minus 4, that is 3. And D starts 10 minus 10, that is 0. So this is we call a backward pass. Okay. So far clear, and any doubt, write a message in chat box. Tomorrow we will meet. Day after tomorrow we will start the fourth unit. Any queries, please write a message. Otherwise, I am ending the session today. Thank you.